Hi there, I'm Kelly Dean from the Tummy Team, and we're going to talk to you a little bit about diastasis recti and the bigger picture functional core weakness. This is the deal. Nobody has diastasis recti without having functional core weakness. We see this time and time again. Diastasis is the separation of the abdominal wall that is really common in prenatal and postpartum women, but really could happen to anyone. And the reason is functional core weakness. And what does that mean? Functional core weakness is basically the muscles around your core not doing what they need to do to hold you up, to stabilize you with fitness activities, with lifestyle activities, with postural requirements of daily life. So if the corset muscle is weak, disconnected, or the pelvis and the rib cage are constantly in collapsed, rounded, or asymmetrical alignments, that corset muscle is not doing what it needs to do to hold you up. And as a result, your body has to find different strategies to stabilize you, which tend to be strategies of bracing or holding your breath or tensing, something that bulges your stomach and pushes on that connective tissue that runs down the center. So a lot of the times we think, oh, I have a diastasis, I have to fix that problem. But when we really look at the big picture, functional core weakness is pretty much an epidemic. If you think about how much we sit in our parents, how many parenting postures put us in collapsed postures, how many different things we do in our fitness routines that have us in crunched, collapsed, bulging, bracing, powering through pain positions and alignments, all of those things put together creates this instability of the core because the outer muscles tend to be stronger than the internal stabilizers, and then we have an issue. And so the cool thing about this is, yes, I'm a physical therapist, and the Tummy Team is a group of physical therapists that work with these conditions, but there's a role to be played across the continuum of fitness instructors, medical professionals, and birth professionals. So really, fitness instructors knowing better how to stabilize the core and not put people in crunched positions, but to balance out the internal and external muscles, that's going to be really important. Medical professionals like chiropractors, physical therapists, even massage therapists, acupuncturists, naturopaths, all of those kinds of people and professionals have a role to play in how we're strengthening the muscles, how we're encouraging alignment, how we're working with balancing out hormones and digestive issues so that the corset muscles do the role that they're supposed to do. And then there's the birth professionals, OBs and midwives, and even labor delivery nurses and doulas and childbirth educators all have a role to play in how to help clients be in better alignments in just how they do everyday things like sitting in the car and standing in line. All of these things play a role in how your body was supposed to function. And if the muscles are balanced out and functioning well, then we don't have these issues where the internal muscles are really weak and the external muscles are really tight, creating this tension on the diastasis or on the connective tissue that creates a diastasis. So, yes, we're all about educating people about what a diastasis is and how to check for it, but the treatment really comes down to treating people for functional core weakness and making it realistic and relevant and meaningful in their everyday life. And we can all play a role in that, okay? Find out more about what we do at thetummyteam.com. We have training for professionals. We're passionate about spreading the word about what we do and how we do it so that we can reach more clients across the world. Thanks so much.